I'm Roger Santiago, head of the Sediment Remediation Unit for Environment and Climate Change Canada. Randle Reef is the largest contaminated sediment site on the Canadian side of the Great Lakes. Environment and Climate Change Canada is leading a project to clean up the site with funding support from the Government of Canada, the Province of Ontario, the Hamilton Port Authority, the City of Hamilton, Stelco, the City of Burlington, and the Regional Municipality of Halton. The Randle Reef site contains approximately 695,000 cubic meters of contaminated sediments at the bottom of the harbor. The contamination is a result of multiple sources over a period of more than 150 years. These sources have included coal gasification, petroleum refining, steel production, municipal waste, sewage effluent, and overland drainage. The sediments are contaminated with polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, commonly known as PAHs, and heavy metals. The PAHs are present in very high concentrations and are of greatest concern because they are known to be persistent, toxic, and carcinogenic. This project is divided into three stages. Stage one involves reconstructing an adjacent shipping pier and constructing the engineered containment facility, or ECF, that acts like a box placed securely on top of the most severely contaminated sediment at the site. Stage two involves dredging the bulk of the remaining contaminated sediments from the surrounding area and placing them inside the ECF. Stage three involves the installation of an environmental cap, which acts as an impermeable barrier atop the ECF. Once completed, the ECF will be developed as a port by the Hamilton Port Authority. Now, let's watch how the ECF was constructed in the first stage of the project. The project involves installing over 3,300 steel sheet piles. The steel required for the project was produced in Nanticoke, Ontario by Stelco Canada as their contribution to the project. These raw steel coils were then made into sheet piles, with the thick outer wall pilings being made by a rolling mill in Iuka, Mississippi, and the inner sealed environmental wall pilings being made in Cambridge, Ontario. The project started in the fall of 2015 with the reconstruction of an adjacent shipping pier. The pier borders some of the most highly contaminated sediment at the Randle Reef site. These sediments will be dredged and placed into the ECF in stage two. The old pier had become degraded and needed to be reconstructed in order to safely carry out future dredging in front of it. Construction supplies were stored in the project staging area and transported by barge to where the ECF was being built in the harbor. Two parallel sheet pile walls were constructed starting from two locations. The outer sheet pile wall is primarily a structural wall, as the pilings are longer and were driven deep into the harbor floor to provide strength to the ECF. While the inner wall is an impermeable sealed barrier that will contain and isolate the contaminated sediments from the harbor. The inner wall also extends deep into the clay at the bottom of the harbor, therefore sealing the facility at its base. Once the walls were constructed, the contaminated sediments were removed from between the walls and placed inside the ECF by a mechanical dredge. Gravel and rock were then placed between the inner wall and the outer wall to provide the ECF with additional structural stability. Air and water quality monitoring of the surrounding area was conducted during these construction activities to ensure that no adverse effects were created by the project. The construction of the ECF began in April 2016 and took 2 years to complete. As you can see, the ECF structure is now situated over top of a large portion of the most contaminated sediments, shown in red. During stage two of the project, the remaining red and orange areas will be dredged and placed inside the ECF. As the ECF reaches its storage capacity, areas of lesser contaminated sediment, shown in yellow, will be managed by the application of a thin layer of sand to provide a new and cleaner substrate. The entire project will take 7 years to complete, with completion expected by 2022. 2 years for the construction of the ECF, 2 years for dredging the contaminated sediment and placing it in the ECF, and 3 years for consolidation and capping of the contaminated sediments in the ECF. Completing the Randle Reef project will improve water quality and reduce contaminant levels in the harbor. Randle Reef is one of two major projects to be completed in order to restore water quality and eventually remove Hamilton Harbor from the list of Great Lakes areas of concern. It is estimated that the project will help generate millions of dollars in economic benefits for the local community, including job creation, business development, and tourism. One last thing, we'll be providing video updates as the project continues. Stay tuned and learn more about it.